My name is Taison Bell. I'm a critical care and infectious disease physician at the University of Virginia. There was a day I was in the ICU and I was talking to one of my nurses about the COVID-19 vaccine. And then I noticed that there were many other nurses who were kind of coming and crowding around. And I actually decided to just do a chalk talk and just talk about the COVID-19 vaccine for my staff. And I think what was kind of a barrier was this assumption that if you're a healthcare worker, if you're a nurse, then you shouldn't have questions about the vaccine, that you should just take it. And these were nurses who were working in the COVID ICU. And we were taking care of pregnant women who were coming in very sick on mechanical ventilation or the breathing machine. So they knew first and forehand how severe COVID-19 could be if they were to get infected. But yet and still, they had a lot of questions about the vaccine. So that was a moment where I understood if the nurses who are working here have questions, and almost everyone probably has his questions. And so we just decided to talk about it. You know, what do we know about the vaccine and its potential to affect your fertility? It's a potential to affect the health of your baby if you're pregnant or if you're breastfeeding, and really to get into that. Now, what's frustrating about the trials is that they did not include women who were pregnant during a time of enrollment. But what we know is that there were women who became pregnant during the course of the vaccine. We know that based on the ingredients in the vaccine, they break down relatively quickly. There's nothing that's expected to cause any harm to the fetus or to the mom. The Pfizer and Moderna have both done trials in animal models to demonstrate that there's no danger to both the developing fetus and to the mother itself. So we have plenty of data points to show us that this is a safe and effective vaccine. But we also talk about, you know, what is the risk of being a woman of childbearing age and getting COVID-19? Because we've seen data showing that it's associated with higher rates of miscarriage, higher rates of preterm labor, and higher rates of women getting sick with COVID-19 and going to the hospital. And so we balance those two effects. And when I've talked to women that were pregnant or thinking about getting pregnant and really thinking through, you know, what are the risks versus the benefits, particularly if you are in the community and potentially getting exposed, it really weighs towards protecting yourself, protecting your health, protecting the health of the baby and getting the vaccine. So for my family members, you know, I have family members who are thinking about getting pregnant, some who are pregnant, and I've advised them all to get the vaccine because I want them to be safe. But I think for each person who has to you know, put yourself in that decision journey, you want to make sure that you have accurate and good information, knowing that over 10,000 women have been vaccinated now who have been pregnant, and we've had no signal that there's anything concerning about that. But we do know that those women are now protected from having bad outcome from COVID-19. That's the message that we have to get out there, that this is a safe thing to do for yourself and for your baby. Speak with your physician as always, but we're really leaning towards making sure that women are protected.